Donald Trump's hopes of returning to the White House have taken another blow, with the former president revealing he's the target of yet another federal investigation. Already the first president in American history to be criminally charged by the Department of Justice, he's now facing further potential federal charges for allegedly trying to overturn the 2020 election results. Our US correspondent Catherine Firkin has more.
Donald Trump back doing what he does best, campaigning and playing the victim.
We have a man, the only way he can get elected is to weaponize the Justice Department, which he's gone around doing.
A strikingly somber former president on the defensive yet again as his legal troubles grow.
We have prosecutors that are evil people. These are evil people, deranged. I call him deranged, just one particular man. I think he's a sick person.
That one man is special counsel Jack Smith, who's already investigating Trump for alleged mishandling of classified documents at Mar-a-Lago, now revealing another indictment could be just days away for election interference. His role in stoking the January 6 riot and his actions before, during and after are likely at the heart of the investigation.
The Capitol was invaded, the electoral count was halted, and the lives of those in the Capitol were put at risk.
This is big trouble for a man with hopes of returning to the White House.
I believe that we're looking at days, potentially weeks, for the next federal indictment of the former president of the United States.
Allies of Trump have been quick to come out swinging.
Yeah, it's absolutely.
If you notice recently, President Trump went up in the polls and was actually surpassing President Biden for re-election. So what do they do now? Weaponize government to go after their number one opponent.
His main challenger was more cautious with his words.
I think it was shown how he was in the White House and didn't do anything while things were going on. He should have come out more forcefully, of course that. But to try to criminalize that, that's a different issue entirely.
But whether his supporters trust in the legal process or not, there's no doubt that yet another trial will present challenges for Trump, who's already navigating an unprecedented and increasingly treacherous road back to the White House. Catherine Firkin for 10 News First, New York.
Help is arriving in Greece as wildfires continue to burn across tinder-dry country near Athens. Italy and France have sent specialist water bombing aircraft, while Romanian firefighters have been sent to the front lines to help exhausted local crews. On the outskirts of Athens, highways were closed and residents have been told to be ready to leave as wildfires sweep across the hillsides towards homes and an oil refinery.
Did they do anything to extinguish any fires? They sent two planes in the afternoon and that was it. That's their plan? Two planes to extinguish a fire that has a 40-kilometre front line.
Fire crews had to make a special visit to a local convent to convince the nuns to leave as fires edge closer to their hilltop home. Canada is still attempting to gain control of hundreds of blazes in its worst fire season on record. There are more than 900 fires burning across the country, with almost 600 of those classified as out of control. Smoke from the blazes is still drifting across the border into the US, exacerbating heatwave conditions and creating some of the worst air quality in the world. Phoenix in Arizona has set a new heat record after experiencing 19 days of temperatures over 43 degrees. The city is sweltering, with the homeless and the elderly the worst affected, and there is little relief in the forecast.
Unfortunately, this 19 days is going to climb to 20, likely 21, 22, 23, even potentially in the mid-20s.
More than 12,000 record-high temperatures have been recorded in the US so far this year. The hottest just yesterday in California's Death Valley, a sweltering 52 degrees. Extra police resources have been deployed onto the streets of Israel after a day of national protest spiralled into social disobedience. Tens of thousands took to the streets, chanting now a well-worn demand that the Prime Minister, Benjamin Netanyahu, abandon his controversial judicial reforms. As the demonstration stretched into the late night, mounted police and water cannon were deployed in an attempt to move the stubborn crowds on. The protests, now in their seventh month, have taken on a sense of urgency as Netanyahu and his allies push ahead with the program. The first stage is expected to become law in a matter of days. America is embroiled in a fresh diplomatic crisis with North Korea after one of its soldiers walked across the border while in South Korea. The Pentagon has confirmed the man's arrest and identified him as an Army private who was on his way back to the US for disciplinary reasons but never got on the plane, instead joining a guided tour. Adding to the tensions, just hours after the arrest, North Korea launched two ballistic missiles into the sea nearby. Las Vegas police have revealed they have searched a house earlier this week in connection to the murder of rapper Tupac Shakur. The police chief told local reporters that detectives are working on the cold case once again, but wouldn't confirm if they have any new leads. Tupac was shot on the Las Vegas Strip after leaving a Mike Tyson fight in 1996. He died a week later.